It's from Jesus where I get my strength.
What?
To overcome every trial and test. To overcome in the wilderness.
Yes.
To overcome every trial. And oh, I messed up, so cut it.
I
just leave it right there.
Here we go. Dice, gloria a Dios por haberme salvado, por darme vida y haberme transformado, por encontrarme entre los perdidos. Reprendo al diablo porque es mi enemigo. En la cruz él creía que ganaba. Cristo crucificado a nosotros sanaba toda enfermedad, de toda contaminación. Por eso quiero hablarte de la salvación. Amen. Soy el camino, la verdad y la vida.
So when I think about reconciliation, I think about who I was before Christ and how I was full of anger and full of rage and self-dysfunction and just had a really bad place in my life. And then just redemption came. And redemption was God reaching out to me. The word says that when we were God's enemies, he died for us. And I never understood what that meant. I never even understood what Christ was. But what I did know was that when he came into my life, he started to deal with some of those areas of redemption and changed my life, and he brought key people into those to help me walk along that journey. People like my cousin Pito. I don't see him much these days, but I'll never forget how he helped me bring me back into the face of God. And I would never forget him talking to me and sharing with me and walking with me as little kids, just going through what we went through. But he was just always my ride or die right there by my side, making me laugh and making me have fun.
We had racial tension. Right, but I always remember being around whites and blacks my whole life. Do you remember that or no? I mean, well, I know your story was a little bit different in the field.
No, this city is known for what happened in the 70s, the racial tension in the 70s. Boston is predominantly Irish, so it was segregated. You knew that even before the Irish came over, like Mattapan used to be our Jewish. We're driving through Mattapan right now. And Mattapan was Jewish.
What do we call Mattapan now?
Murderpan, Dorchester, Drugchester, Roxbury, Rockberry, like crack rock.
Or like Blackberry. Okay.
But then when there was the, it was happening all over where the white population was moving into the suburbs, leaving the city and moving into the suburbs. So the Jewish left and blacks and Latinos started coming in. And like I said, there was racial tensions because you had to have the busing era, the busing crisis, where they were like, okay, we need to mix the schools. So we're not gonna have this separation anymore. And at first, the Irish were against it. You know, so that's what Boston was known for, what happened with the busing crisis, okay? But like he said, growing up, I know there's always like a little racism here and there, but what I remember also growing up, I hung out with blacks, I hung out with Spanish, I hung out with white people, Irish. You have West Roxbury, Dedham area, which is like Greek. I went to school and there was Greeks in my high school and we all got along. I remember walking towards South Boston and they always say, be careful, you could get jumped. But I went to South Boston, I didn't get jumped, you know? And that was predominantly white. So, you know, everybody has different experiences.
In order to get to a place of reconciliation comes humility. And humility is where you just really humble yourself to what this thing is, because in reconciliation, there's two elements. There's the element of forgiveness and there's the element of repentance. And so humility makes me think of a lot of pastors like Pastor Bruce Wall, who just really walked with my life. He didn't even know me. He didn't know who I was, but he went out of his way to advocate on my behalf, to help me get out of prison, to change my life around, to just intervene in my life. And what was interesting was he was a black man and I was a Spanish man, and we didn't have nothing in common, but yet we had one thing in common, and that was Christ. God goes out of his way to extend his love. And when you are overwhelmed and saturated with his love, it's easy for you to then forgive and let go of certain areas of your life. And when I think about love, I think of Miguel and Elizabeth Prieto. Man, those people, when I first met him, he kissed me and I didn't know who he was. I didn't know what that was. I didn't even know what a man kissing me made me feel weird and awkward at the time. But what the next couple of seconds, what came was an overwhelming sense of love. And that's kind of what God does for us. He sends people like Mr. Prieto and Missy Prieto to be representation of his love, so that once you embrace love, you can't have anger, because anger and love and hate and love just do not mix, are not in the same place. And so true love is God, and God's love sends his ambassadors of love to help you cope with life and help you overcome this anger inside. I remember I had a lack, a void inside of my life, and God sent different people to me. One of the most amazing stories is this white guy who named Scott Larson, who the first time I met him, he punched me. You know, the street in me were ready to go back and ready to go to war, but there was something different about his punch. He was playing with me. And because I lacked a father figure growing up and didn't know what that meant, the moment he punched me, I felt like God saying, I want to play with you. I'm sending a father. I'm sending a brother, a big brother to you to just come and help fill that void. And again, it was people like Scott Larson, people like Virginia Ward, who I didn't even know who she was. And she felt, she saw leadership in me. She saw potential in me. And she didn't even know my name. All she said is, this is a Puerto Rican guy somewhere in this Christian movement out here in the city of Boston that I want to reach out to him. And she went out of her way and reached out to me, and I'm forever grateful, because her reaching out to me have allowed me, given me new opportunities and new experiences that I would have never experienced if it wasn't for somebody like her. Many, many, many years ago, I hit one of the darkest seasons of my life. I use it in my sermons a lot. For 8 months, yeah. I didn't pray. For 8 months, I didn't read my Bible. For 8 months, I didn't go to church. For 8 months, I was just angry at God. I was just in a bad place. Just very, in a very dark, I mean, the darkest season of my life, I would say. And I didn't know this cat back then. But there was this song that I used to listen to. And for whatever reason, that song caused a reaction, like I guess what David felt with Saul. Or what Saul felt with David. What Saul felt with David, that he says that every time David would play, he would feel peace.
Wow.
And so this guy would sing a song, and for those 8 months, my life just kept on going. It was like pumping spirit, energy, positivity, soul into my soul. So when you ask me who I am, I could tell you that I was a man full of anger and full of self-hate, and a man confused and lost that has been found. And I have been found because Christ went out of his way when I was his enemy. He died for me, and he did everything he had to do to reconcile me to him. And so today I'm a walking reconciliation. I may not know everything and how to reconcile effectively with everybody and all those types of situations, but what I do know is, as I reconcile with Christ, I want to reconcile with you. And so I just want to tell you, if that's part of who I am, a man that just is grateful for everything that God has done. I am Eli Hernandez.